Welcome to the Dapper Dog. Today we're going to take a look at the island of Croatia. After being stuck in the cold, just relaxing and laying on the beach all day, dining out at the world's most famous restaurants, or enjoying the sun setting over the ocean at night sound like a great getaway? Well, then stay tuned. We will show you what Croatia has to offer for fun after you've found luxurious accommodations. Crisscross. Historic cities and unspoiled nature are some of Croatia's top attractions, but if you're also looking for gorgeous medieval cities or sunny tropical beaches, then this city is definitely the best place for you. Today, the Dapper Dog brings you attractions, restaurants, and activities in Croatia. Subscribe to the Dapper Dog and ring the bell icon to get regular updates on our latest uploads. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up button and share it with your friends. Now here are Croatia's top-rated attractions. Diocletian's Palace in Split. Split, Croatia's second biggest city after Zagreb, was established within the ancient Roman walls of the huge Diocletian's Palace. Situated overlooking the Adriatic Sea, it was built by Roman Emperor Diocletian, who retired here in AD 305. Square in plains, it's more fortress than the palace, and actually housed the emperor's personal garrison. The palace has four monumental gates, three accessible from the land and one that originally opened directly onto the water. And within the walls, things to see include the magnificent arcaded courtyard, Paris style, where you'll also find the Cathedral of St. Dominus with its elegant bell tower. The fun thing to do at night is to visit and enjoy the illuminated ruins. While during the day, concerts and entertainment are frequently held by the old town, is a pedestrian-only zone and has been proclaimed a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Zlatni Rat Beach. Croatia's most photographed beach has to be the remarkable Zlatni Rat. Located in Bol on the south coast of Brac, this unusual landform known as a spit is made up of fine pebbles and runs 500 meters perpendicular to the coast. Depending on local winds and currents, it moves and changes shape from season to season. Backed by a cluster of pine trees offering shade and overlooked by the rocky heights of Vidova Gora Mountain, it is lined in summer with sunbeds and umbrellas and is widely considered one of Europe's top beaches. The sea is warm enough to swim from June through September, and some people even manage to stretch the bathing season out to May and October too. Extra attractions on the beach include water sports such as paddle boats, sea kayaks, and banana boat rides. Zlatni Rat is also Croatia's top windsurfing destination. Zagreb's Gornji Grad. In the Croatian capital, Zagreb, the main sightseeing area is the medieval Gornji Grad district. Here, popular tourist attractions include the cathedral with its neo-Gothic facade, twin steeples, and treasury with its large collection of religious art and artifacts. The Croatian Parliament, the Church of St. Mark with its famous colored tiled roof, and the 13th century Tower of Lotskrak, which you can climb for fantastic views over the city and the surrounding area. Plitvice Lakes National Park. Croatia's most visited inland attraction, Plitvice Lakes National Park encompasses steep forested hillsides surrounding 16 emerald blue lakes, connected by a succession of thundering waterfalls. A network of footpaths and wooden bridges crisscrosses the park, and the entrance ticket includes boat rides across the lakes. Thanks to the lush, pristine nature, the park is haven for wild animals, including wolves and bears, as well as owls, eagles, and falcons. There are also several hotels on the edge of the park, should you wish to stay that night. You can visit Plitvice on organized sightseeing tours by bus from Zagreb and Zadar. Dubrovnik Old Town Walls. Dubrovnik, Croatia's most glamorous tourist destination and a UNESCO World Heritage Site, centers on the magnificent Old Town area, contained with sturdy medieval defensive walls. Any first-time sightseeing tour of the city should begin with a walk around these sturdy old ramparts, which incorporates fortresses, towers, and cannons along the way. You will also likely enter the Old Town through the famous Pile Gate, built in 1537, and one of the city's most impressive structures. From high up on the walls, you can enjoy amazing views over the Old Town rooftops and out across the glistening Adriatic Sea. And other fun things to do include exploring the Stratum, a wide 300 meter long pedestrian thoroughfare lined with boutiques, cafes, and restaurants that's famous for its white limestone cobblestones. Mljet National Park. The western third of the island of Mljet has been designated as a national park. It is largely covered by dense woodland. It centers on two interconnected turquoise saltwater lakes, one of which has an islet capped by a 12th century Benedictine monastery, which you can visit by taxi boat. Mljet National Park is popular with nature lovers. The park offers plenty of things to do, including exploring the numerous paths that run through the woodland, but there's also a 9-kilometer trail that runs around the perimeter of the lakes, making it ideal for walking or mountain biking. The area is also popular for swimming and activities such as kayaking. Bijuni National Park. Lying off the Estrane Peninsula, the archipelago of scattered pine-scented islets has been designated a national park. The largest island, Belle Bijun, is covered with beautifully landscaped parkland and is open to visitors year-round. The former president of Yugoslavia, Tito, used to entertain visiting foreign dignitaries here, and some of them brought him exotic animals as gifts, the descendants of which are now in show in the small safari park. Elephants from India, antelopes from Zambia, and zebras from Guinea are the main attractions. And this island is also home to an abundance of unique flora and fauna, along with evidence that dinosaurs once roamed here. Rovinja. Located in northwest Croatia on the Istrian Peninsula, the Venetia-era seaside town of Rovinj is made up of pastel-colored houses ringing a pretty fishing harbor and presided over by a hilltop church with an elegant bell tower. Besides the nearby pebble beaches, the main tourist attraction is the Batana Eco Museum on the seafront, which tells the story of the Batana, a type of wooden boat used by local fishermen. There are also plenty of top-rated hotels, upmarket seafood restaurants, and art galleries to explore. The locals speak a dialect that mixes both the Croatian and Italian languages, and the nearest airport is in Pula. Šibenik. Boasting a rich history that can be traced back as far as the 11th century, the attractive Dalmatian city of Šibenik has much to offer tourists to Croatia. While not always as busy as other popular destinations within this beautiful country, there's no shortage of great things to do here. You can start by exploring the perfectly preserved historic old town center. Here you'll find elegant 15th and 16th century architecture, along with numerous attractions worth visiting. Also worth visiting are the remains of St. John's Fortress, perched high upon a hill overlooking the town and boasting magnificent views over the Adriatic, and the equally important St. Michael's Fortress, popular for the traditional cultural performances hosted on its delightful open-air stage. Trogir. Widely regarded as one of the top tourist destinations on Croatia's spectacular Dalmatian coast, the attractive seaside town of Trogir is a delightful vacation destination to explore. With a rich history that dates all the way back to its founding in 380 BC, Trogir has at various times been ruled by Greeks, Romans, Hungarians, and Venetians. Now a UNESCO World Heritage Site and honor bestowed on the town in 1997, Trogir offers tourists no end of fun things to do. In addition to its main top-rated hotels and accommodation options, visitors are spoiled for choice when seeking a good seafood restaurant or getting in some souvenir shopping. Well, thanks to the careful preservation of its many old buildings, history buffs and sightseers alike have plenty of attractions to visit, most of them to be found within the confines of the town walls dating back to the 1400s. Some examples of elegant Romanesque and Renaissance-style architecture can be seen everywhere along the town's medieval streets or lining the attractive waterfront promenade. Zadar's Romanesque Churches. Zadar's car-free old town is built on a small peninsula jutting out into Croatia's Dalmatian coast. Said to be the country's oldest continually inhabited city, it can trace its roots back as far as the Stone Age. Its top tourist attractions are its many fine Romanesque churches. Most of them built between the 19th and 13th centuries are filled with superbly preserved religious paintings and ornate golden treasures. And also be sure to check out the 19th century pre-Romanesque church of St. Donatus, the 11th century church of St. Mary, and the Cathedral of Anastasia, and the church of St. Chrysogonus, both from the 12th century. Other things to do include visiting the Museum of Ancient Glass, as well as two popular modern installations, the Sea Organ and the Greeting to the Sun, both on the seafront close to the tip of the peninsula. And one of the best free things to do in Zadar is to simply relax on picturesque Kovalar Beach, a stretch of sand and pebbles that backs onto a lovely park area. Rijeka. The attractive city of Rijeka, often overlooked by vacationers to the Dalmatian coast, is well worth adding to your Croatia travel itinerary. In addition to the bonus of having to deal with fewer crowds, this long, important port city offers plenty of attractions and things to do for those who do visit. The highlights include exploring the old town's well-preserved cobble streets and lanes, each lined with splendid examples of townhomes and dwellings, as well as old shops and places of trade that was built in the 1700s. Be sure to visit the magnificent Trast Castle, built above the town in the 13th century and accessible via a lovely pathway that also leads to the nearby Church of Our Lady of Trast, and also a mix of great art galleries and museums. Croatia's largest carnival and the nearby Rišnjac National Park, and there's no end of good excuses to visit this charming town. Sailing around Kornati National Park. Spreading over an area of some 320 square kilometers, it's 35 kilometers long and 13 kilometers wide. The Kornati Archipelago encompasses 89 scattered islets, big and small. Rocky and arid with little fertile soil, the islets are practically uninhabited, though there are some very basic stone cottages dotted here and there. It is originally built as one-room shelters by local fishermen and shepherds. They're now often used as holiday retreats or seasonal seafood restaurants. The best way to explore this stunning, beautifully coastal region is by private sailing boat, with the nearest charter base being located in Vagrad na Moru, the pretty town of Korčula. The town of Korčula, the chief settlement on the island of the same name in South Dalmatia, sits snugly on a tiny peninsula. Protected by medieval walls and towers, its car-free stone alleys are laid out in a herringbone bone pattern so as to give shelter from the prevailing winds. Packed with centuries-old aristocratic stone buildings, Korčula was built at a time when the island was under Venetian rule. The top points of interest include Marco Polo's house, said to be the birthplace of the renowned 13th-century explorer. But one of the best things to do is to catch a performance of the Maresca Sword Dance, a traditional dance stage for tourists just outside the town walls on summer evenings. Hvar Town. Many tourists visit Croatia to explore the blissful Dalmatian islands, of which the most fashionable is Hvar. Here, the trendy city of Hvar is home to some of the country's top hotels and best seafood restaurants, and way back to the years spent under Venetian rule. Around 1420 to 1797, its car-free old town is made up of spacious main square overlooked by a 16th century cathedral, a pretty fishing harbor, and a hilltop fortress. Hvar is popular with yachters and celebrities, as well as travelers who come here to enjoy its beaches and water sports. It is served by ferry from Split. That is it from us. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give us a like and share it with your friends. Subscribe to the Dapper Dog for more amazing videos. Don't forget to ring the bell icon to stay updated with our content. Tomorrow we will bring you the luxury hotels and resorts in Cambodia. See you in the next video.